life is very long. TSL. I mean, you have to give him credit for it because he bothered to write it down. He wasn't the first to say it. Certainly wasn't the first to think. But he wrote it down on a sheet of paper and he signed his name to it. And the four-eyed clerk was a genius, so every time you said it, you have to say his name after. Life is very long. T.S. Eliot. Absolutely goddamn right. Especially since he lived to be 76 or something. A very long time. Especially in those days. And he was only in his 30s when he wrote it, so I always figured that he had some inside dope. Give the devil his due. Not many poets could have went through his trials and come out the other side all brilliantined and double-breasted and Anglican. Not hard to imagine. Given Eliot's first wife, the lovely Viv, how Hart Crane or John Berryman would have reacted just a foot race to nearest bridge. Olympian suicidalist. But not Eliot. Following sufficient years of ecclesiastical guilt, just plopper in the asylum and get on with the day. God almighty, you have to admire the purity of the survivor's instinct. Berryman, old goat, the world is gradually becoming a place where I do not care to be anymore. I don't know what it says about me, but I've always had an affinity for the damaged. Probably nothing good. But I admire the hell out of Eliot, the poet. The person I can't identify.
Son of a bitch!
Violet, my wife. She takes pills. Sometimes a great many. And the pill she takes eliminates, among other things, her equilibrium. Fortunately, the pills my wife takes eliminates her need for an equilibrium. So she falls when she rambles. She doesn't ramble much. My wife takes pills, and I drink. That's the bargain we struck. Just one paragraph out of our marriage contract. Cruel covenant. My wife takes pills, and I drink. I do not drink because my wife takes pills. As far as my wife taking pills because I drink, I learned long ago not to speak for my wife. The reasons we partake are any more inconsequential. The facts are, my wife takes pills and I drink. And these facts over time have made burdensome the maintenance of typical American routine. Paying the bills, the purchase of goods, or the cleaning of clothes, or carpets, or crackers. Rather than once more assume the mantle of guilt, vowing abstinence with my fingers crossed in a queasy hope of righting our ship, I've chosen to turn
my wife
over to a higher power and join the ranks of the hiring class. It's not a decision with which I am entirely comfortable. I know how I belong to my own dirty enemies. Done so all my life. Me, my wife. But I'm finding it getting in the way of my drinking. Something can be said for sobriety, but very little. Very little again. Now you are here. The place isn't in such bad shape. Not yet. Done all right for myself. I've managed. Why, just last night, I burnt an awful lot of debris. You know, a simple utility bill can mean so much. bullets to a living nurse. Once they pass, though, after they pass, the words and numbers just seem like otherworldly symbols. It's just people. Worse than white people. Oh, here, this is clean.
Thank you.
I apologize for the temperature in here. My wife is cold-blooded, and not just in a metaphorical sense. She doesn't believe in air conditioning, as if it were a thing to be disbelieved.
My daddy was the same way. I'm used to it.
Well, I knew Mr. Youngberg, you know.
You knew Daddy?
Well, small town. He used to buy, many a watermelon from his fruit stand. Some summers he would sell fireworks, right?
Yes, sir.
Well, I bought Roman candles for my children. He did pass, didn't he?
Yes, sir.
That's how?
He had a heart attack, fell into a flatbed truck full of wine grapes.
Wine grapes? In Oklahoma. I'm sorry.
Thank you.
May I ask about the name? He was Youngberg, and you are?
Manavada.
Manavada.
I went back to the original language.
And does that mean Youngberg?
Yes.
And taking the name, that was your choice. Cheers!
Yeah.
At night. Oh, within that ancient house. Immense. Black. Dead. Anonymous.
Fail!
Yes!
Did you push?
What?
Did you?
What, dear?
Oh, God damn it. Did you? Are the police here?
No!
Is this a window? Am I looking out a window?
Can you come here?
Hello.
Hello.
I didn't know you were entertaining.
This is Jonna, the young woman that I was telling you about.
You tells me a woman?
Pardon?
A woman? Woman.
The young woman who I'm hiring to look after the place.
You tell me woman's now's the thing. I thought you had meant the other woman.
What other woman?
Huh?
I'm planning to hire her to cook and clean and drive you to the clinic and take you...
In the interest of civil action and in your particular ways of speaking, I thought that you had thought you meant the other woman to be hired.
I don't understand you.
Hello.
Hello.
I'm sorry that I'm like this.
Yes, ma'am.
I'm Violet. What's your name?
Jonna.
You're pretty.
Thank you.
Are you an Indian?
Yes.
What kind?
Cheyenne.
Do you think I'm pretty?
Yes, ma'am.
Like this?
Oh, careful.
Oh, you're the house now. I'm sorry. I took some medicine for my muscular.
Well, why don't you go on back up to bed, sweetheart?
Why don't you fuck a fucking sow's ass?
All right.
I'm sorry. I'll be sickly sweet. I will be so sweet. I'll be in alias sweet.
I believe I mentioned on the phone that Dr. Burke recommended you. He seems to feel you're qualified to handle the needs of our household.
I have a year towards my nursing certificate. Close to community college. But I had to drop out with Daddy and I saw my mom and grandma through tough times.
Dr. Burke said you were struggling for work.
I've been cleaning houses and babysitting.
Well, he did tell you we wanted to live in.
Yes, sir.
We keep unusual hours here. Try not to differentiate between night and day. I doubt you'll be able to maintain anything like a healthy routine.
I need the work.
The work itself? Very mundane. I myself require very little personal attention. Thrive without it. Sort of like a human cactus. My wife has been diagnosed with a touch of cancer, so she'll need to be driven to Tulsa for her final chemotherapy treatment. You're welcome to use that American-made behemoth out there in the carport. You're welcome to use anything. Everything. All this garbage we've acquired. And if you're going to live here, I want you to live here. You understand?
Yes, sir.
Please, call me Beverly. Do you have any questions?
What kind of cancer does she have?
I didn't say. Oh my God, I almost forgot the punchline. Mouth cancer.
What kind of pills does she take?
Valium, Vicodin, Darvon, Darvocet, Percodin, Percocet, Xanax for fun, Oxycontin, pinch. Black Molly's once, just to see if I was paying attention. And of course, Dilaudid. Mustn't forget Dilaudid. My wife, Violet. Violet, my wife, doesn't believe that she needs treatment for her habit. She's been down that road before and come out clean as a whistle. And then she chose for herself this reality. You were about to ask why she isn't currently seeking treatment, weren't you?
No, sir.
Oh. Good. Just one second. My last refuge. My books. Oh. Simple pleasures. Like finding wild onions along the road. Or requited love.
T.S. Eliot.
Read it or not, it's not a job requirement. That's for your enjoyment. Feel free to read any of my books. Here we go around the prickly pear. The prickly pear. The prickly pear. Here we go around the prickly pear. At 5 o'clock in the morning.
Involved in somebody else's marriage.
Not anyone
sister I sure as hell do. I'm his sister. She knows what I mean. But when I took off like that, I, without saying a word, I said, just take all these damn books and put them on the front porch. Take everything out, put it in a pile, and you build yourself a bonfire. Throw all his papers and everything in.
You don't burn a man's books.
Will you stop? You keep contradicting me.
His books didn't do anything. Well, his possessions aren't responsible.
Oh, she didn't do it anyway.
Of course she didn't do it.
Let me tell you something, Charlie Aiken. You ever get any ideas about walking off on me, you better believe.
I ain't going anywhere.
You better believe I'll give you just 3 days to get your head straight, and it's all going up in a blaze of glory.
I ain't going anywhere.
If you did.
I'm not.
Not that Charlie has any books laying around. I don't think I've ever seen Charlie read a book in my life.
Is that a criticism? Does that bother you?
Well, I have it. Tell me the last book you read.
God damn it.
You can't tell me the last book you read.
Beverly was a teacher. Teachers read books. I'm in the upholstery business. People in the upholstery business know me.
And you still can't tell me the last book you read.
This girl's concerned about her daddy's whereabouts. She doesn't need to sit around and listen to us.
Well, I think we're all concerned about Beverly.
Then what in the hell are you needling me for?
Well, you know, he came back, though, and they worked things out. He'll come back again. I know he will.
I think this time is different.
Oh, I think so, too.
Why?
Because this time...
I'm not asking you. Why do you think this time's different?
Because I think back then they were trying.
Which is what I was going to say. Beverly was a very complicated man.
I know.
Stop saying he was.
He was. He is a very complicated man.
Yeah, but in a kind of quiet way.
Oh, kind of like Charles.
Yes. Like little
Charles.
Oh, he's
nothing like little Charles. Oh,
she
no.
Just means
no,
in her quiet, complicated way.
No. Little Charles is not complicated. No, little Charles is not complicated. He's just not smart.
He's an observer.
All he can observe is the TV set.
So you can't even see Ivy's point?
No.
That Beverly and little Charles share some sort of complication?
You have to be smart to be complicated.
That's our boy. Are you saying our boy isn't smart?
Yes, that's what I'm saying.
What's the matter with you? Your cousin's very smart.
God, I'm sweating. Are you sweating?
Yes, I'm sweating. Oh, it's 90 degrees
in here. Feel my back.
I want to feel your back.
Come on, feel it. Sweat's okay. Just dripping.
Yeah, well, I'll leave.
Come on, feel it.
No.
Come on, give me your hand. You feel my back. No. Sweat's just dripping.
Yes. This stuff, this business with the shade, stick with the shade.
Oh, that's been a couple years now.
Do you know its purpose?
Oh, you can't tell it's night or day.
I think that's the purpose.
Well, I don't know, but I don't think that's healthy.
It's not. The body needs some of it.
Wait, do you know which one of them decided?
Oh, well, can't really see Dad taking the initiative.
I suppose not. I don't know about you all, but I find this whole setup depressing. You know, a person's environment is very important to their health. And what the hell? Is that an Eric Clapton album?
Mm-hmm.
Is I an Eric Clapton fan? Don't do that.
The body needs some art.
It's nighttime. And this isn't your place. You don't come into somebody else's home and start changing.
Can you believe it's been 2 years since we've been here?
Well, said they called the hospitals with no Beverly.
Is this the Highway Patrol?
No, not the Highway Patrol. The sheriff. The Gilbo boy.
Gilbo? Don't tell me C.J. Gilbo's the sheriff here now.
No, not C.J. His boy Dion.
Oh, I was going to say.
boy been to school with the girls. Was he in your class, I
mean? Barb's class, I think.
Is that right?
Who's this man?
Oh, see, Jim Gilmore, boy we grew up with. Mean little son of a bitch, juvenile delinquent.
This boy Dion's the sheriff now.
What?
Was it Freeman? Is he a preacher's son?
Well, yes, he's a preacher. He was a preacher's son. Your father did tell you that. Yes,
he went to the penitentiary, remember?
That's right, I remember that. For killing, what was it?
A boxer.
For killing a man's boxer dog.
Yep, his boy Dion's the sheriff now. You know I sent you that subscription to the Powhatan Journal Capital. Don't you read it?
No, I don't read it.
So you told some big shots to keep up with us small town folks?
No, I don't read it.
Well, if you'd read it, you'd know that his boy Dion is the sheriff now.
What hospitals did they check?
I don't know. They rattled off a bunch of them.
Well, did he say anything else?
Pontoon boat's missing.
Mom!
He said he sent a patrolman out to the dock to see if anybody's seen him, but everybody's pontoon boat is gone.
Oh, no!
I mean, he said they've had a couple of boats stolen in the past little while, but he didn't think anything of it. He's just a little concerned.
Why do you think that there's a chance that Bev loaded up that boat on that trailer and took it out of there? I mean, if he was...
No, trailer's out by the shed. I saw it when we pulled up.
Excuse me, dear. But I'll trouble you for another beer.
God damn it, she's not a waitress.
What? I know that.
Then get your own beer.
I'll get it.
I don't believe you. Sitting here watching the baseball game and drinking beers. Don't you have any idea of the situation around you? This situation is fraught.
Am I supposed to sit here like a statue? You're drinking whiskey.
I'm having a cocktail.
That's straight whiskey.
Just show a little class.
No, I don't think we need to sit here crying in the dark.
Well, since you've got everything out, figured out, let's just party down.
Mary Faye.
Let's just sit Indian gal from the kitchen and have whip us up some cheese conies and let's call a few friends.
Ooh, cheese conies sounds good.
It does, doesn't it? Do you feel something cooking?
Yeah.
Let's go to the kitchen and see what it is.
What do you need me for? I got the Cardinals on.
Oh, just come on.
No, that's not good news about that boat.
Did you call Barb?
Yes.
Did you call this morning? What'd she say?
She said she's on her way.
How's she getting here?
She and Bill are coming.
Is she driving?
I doubt it.
Why?
Boulder's a long way.
Was she bringing Jean?
Oh, I don't know.
When'd she say she's getting here?
She didn't say. She just said she was on her way.
What'd you tell her?
I told her that Dad was missing.
That it?
Is there anything else?
Well, did you tell her how long?
5 days.
Did you tell her that?
I think so.
What'd she say?
She said she was on her way.
Oh, God damn it, Avi. Tell me what she said. Was she irritated? Was she amused? What did she say?
She said she was on her way.
God damn your father for putting me through this, for leaving me to handle this. You seen that office, that paperwork, that mess? I can't make heads or tails of it. And he hired this Indian girl over a week ago to live in his house, and now I have a stranger in my house. I don't know what to say to her. What's her name?
Jonna.
He always paid the bills, and he made the phone calls, and now I have to handle it? You know, this house, it's falling apart around me. Something about the sump pump or the basement or the foundation. I don't know what to do about it. I can't do this by myself.
I called Karen.
What'd she say?
She said she'd try to get here.
Well, she'd be a big fat help just like you. I need Barb.
I don't know what Barb's going to be able to do.
What did you do to your hair?
I had it straightened.
You had it straightened? Why would somebody do that?
I don't know.
Why did you do that?
I just wanted to change.
You're a pretty girl, Ivy. You're one of the prettiest of my girls, but you always look like such a schlub.
Do I need makeup?
Oh, every woman needs makeup. Don't let anybody tell you any different. You know, the only woman that was pretty enough to go without makeup was Elizabeth Taylor, and she wore a ton. Sit up straight.
Mom?
Well, your shoulders are slumped, and you don't have any makeup on, and your hair is all straight. You look like a lesbian. You know you're a pretty enough girl, and you can get a decent man if you spruce up a bit. That is all I'm saying.
I am not looking for a man.
I don't know why. Everybody needs somebody.
I am not looking for a man.
Well, just because there are a lot of losers out there, and you found
one. Oh, Barry was not a loser.
Barry was an asshole, and I warned you about him from the start when he showed up here in his little electric car and that stupid orange beard and, oh, that turban.
Oh, it was not a turban.
You know, I don't understand some of the choices you make. You are 43 years old.
44.
44 years old. Maybe you're past the point of having kids, and that is okay if you don't want them. But aren't you interested in finding a husband?
A husband. In Paul Huska.
You don't meet people where you live. You meet them where you work. And you work at a college. Don't tell me there aren't people coming through the doors of that library every day.
You want me to marry a student? Some 18-year-old boy from one of these thick towns.
Well, there are still teachers on the Tulsa campus, aren't there? I mean, there were when your father worked there.
Barry was a teacher at TU.
Environmental studies? Barry was a loser.
He was not a loser.
Well, he dumped you, didn't he?
Oh, he did not dump me. It just didn't work out between us.
Fine. Oh, okay. You're right. I'll get it right eventually. You know, maybe if you just want to live and make it, things would work out between the two of you. How many was that?
I wasn't counting. Is your mouth burning?
Like a son of a bitch. My tongue is on fire.
Should you be smoking?
Should anybody be smoking?
You have cancer of the mouth.
Ivy, I have enough to worry about right now without you getting on me.
I'm not getting on you.
Oh, leave it alone.
Are you scared?
Of course I'm scared. And your comfort. Thank God one of my girls stuck around. You know, my generation, we stayed together.
That was a different time.
No shit. Did you call Aunt Faye?
Aunt Faye's here.
I know that, dummy. Did you call her?
I thought you did.
I don't know. I don't remember.
You've got a lot on your mind.
She means to come in here and tell me what's going
on. I don't know how Uncle Charlie stands it.
He smokes a lot of grass.
He does.
Oh, he smokes a lot of grass.
Grass? You say grass.
Well, what do you call it?
Hey, are you with the Clapton now?
What?
Eric Clapton. You have an Eric Clapton album.
Oh, I've had that forever.
I've never seen it.
Oh, I like it. It's got a nice beat. I'm not old, you know.
No.
What was Jean doing?
Smoking.
I wish you wouldn't encourage that.
I haven't encouraged anything.
I don't know. There's just something funny about the way you say smoking. Like you admire her for getting hooked at 14.
Are you ready for this?
No.
All right, then. Just take a second.
God damn it, it's hot.
Well?
Oh, I know it. Colorado spoiled me.
That's one of the reasons we got out of here in the first place.
No. It's not.
So you suppose your mother's turned on the air conditioner?
You kidding me? Remember the parakeets?
Parakeets?
I never told you about parakeets. So, she got a parakeet for some insane reason, and the little fucker croaked after about 2 days. So she went back to the pet store and raised hell, and they gave her another parakeet. That one died after just 1 day. So she went back to the pet store and they gave her another parakeet, and that one died too. So the chick from the pet store came out here to see just what in hell this serial parakeet killer was doing to bump off these birds.
And?
The heat. They were too hot. They were dying from the heat. These are tropical birds, all right? They live in the fucking tropics. What were these people thinking?
What people?
The jokers who settled this place, the Germans, the Dutch, the Irish. I mean, who saw this flat, hot, nothing and planted their flag? I mean, we fucked the Indians for this.
Well, genocide always seemed like such a good idea at the time.
Oh, right. You need a little hindsight.
Anyway, if you're asking me to explain the creepy nature of the Midwest, well, you're just asking the
wrong... Hey, please! This is not the Midwest. Michigan is the Midwest. God knows why. This is the plains. A state of mind, right? Like some spiritual affliction. Like the blues.
Right, and it's like, hey, are you okay?
Me, I'm fine. I just got the plains.
No. What, is she smoking a fucking cigar?
She's coming. Hey, kiddo, you ready?
Yeah, sure.
Oh, you're precious. Sorry. Hot flash. Whew. All right. Here goes.
Mom!
Really? No, honest, Barbara. He put a drink himself into so worked up about that safety deposit box. We kept an awful lot of cash in that box. Oh, and jewelry, really expensive jewelry. You know, I had a ring appraised, at a diamond ring, appraised at over $7,000.
Wait, I'm missing something. Why do you care about the safety deposit box?
Well, I know what you say about it, but your father and I, we had an arrangement that if something were to happen to one of us, the other one would go and empty out that safety deposit box.
Because?
Well, it gets rolled into the estate and then it goes pro.
Right, that's right.
You're such a fucking cynic.
Oh, I knew you disapprove.
Okay, fine. So what about the safety deposit box?
Well, Monday, I had to wait until Monday to get into that safety deposit box, and after I emptied it out, I called the sheriff, and then I reported him missing on Monday.
And you're just calling me today? On Thursday?
I didn't call you.
You had Ivy call me 5 days later!
Well, I didn't want to upset you.
Jesus Christ.
So, Vi, you can't think of some event that might have triggered his leaving? You know, some incident?
You mean like a fight?
Yeah.
We fought plenty, but no, he just went and walked out that door right there.
Maybe he wanted to get away from you.
Oh, that's nice of you to say.
Hey, that's no crime. Being married is hard.
Under the best of circumstances.
But no, I'll see you later, or I'm taking a walk. Good old unfathomable dad.
Oh, your father. When I first fell in love with him, whew. Was his mystery? Oh, it would just knock you out. You knew that if he'd just say something. But no, he would just stand there, a little smile on his face. Sexy.
Yeah, that mystery can cut both ways.
But so, Vi, you can't think of anything different or unusual that might have happened?
Oh, he hired that Indian girl a few days before he left. And now I have a stranger in my house. I don't know what to say to her.
You don't want her here.
She's a stranger in my house. I've got an Indian in my house.
Hey, come on, bud. You got a problem with Indians?
I don't know what to say to an Indian.
They're called Native Americans.
Oh, who calls them that? Who makes that decision?
They're what they like to be called.
They're not any more Native than me.
In fact, they are.
What is wrong with Indians?
Why is it so hard to call people what they want?
Why don't we just call dinosaurs Native Americans while we're at it?
Well, she may be Indian, but she makes the best goddamn cherry pie I ever eaten.
It is good, isn't it?
A cook? That don't make any sense. We don't eat.
That sounds healthy.
No, I mean we eat cheese and saltines or ham sandwich, but I can't think of the last time that stove turned on. Years.
And now you get biscuits and gravy. Kind of nice, huh?
Yeah, good you now. But you'll be gone soon enough and never return. Oh, when's the last time you were here?
I don't want to discuss it.
Oh, really? Now, I don't remember.
I'm very dutiful, Mom. I call, I write.
You do not write!
I send presents on birthdays and Mother's Day.
Oh, because you're dutiful?
Don't you?
Come on, now.
You are grown-up people. Rhoda, you don't
win
too
long. I have a lot of obligations. I have a daughter about to start high school.
Oh, is that right? Last time I saw her, she's grade school.
I won't talk about this with you right now.
I don't really care about you two, but, you know, I'd like to see my granddaughter every now and again.
Well, you're seeing her now.
Now your father, you broke his heart when you left.
That is wildly unfair.
Now, am I going to have to separate you two? Come on.
What was I supposed to do? Colorado offered Bill twice the money he was making at TU.
Now, why do you even bring
that
up?
And you were willing to hire me, too. Oh, don't think Dad wouldn't have jumped at the chance Bill got.
Oh, now, you are wrong there. You would have never gotten Beverly Weston out of Oklahoma. And don't think he didn't get plenty of offers after Metalark came out.
I'm sure.
You know, after Metalark was published, he got offers from all over the country. Lot better places in Colorado.
Oh, now you want to knock Colorado?
Well, it's not hard to do.
Barbara.
Daddy gave me his blessing and I didn't even ask for it.
Oh, sweat told you.
Come on now, everybody's a little bit on edge.
Now you're going to tell me the true story. Some terrible shit Daddy said behind my back.
Bye, come on.
Your daddy never said terrible things about you behind your back. He just told me he was disappointed in you because he thought you had settled.
Is that supposed to be some sort of comment on Bill? Daddy never said anything like that to you.
Your father thought you had talent as a writer.
If he thought that, and I doubt he did, he was wrong. Anyway, what difference does it make? It's my life. I can do what I want. So you're saying Daddy was disappointed in me because I settled for a beautiful family and a teaching career. Is that what you're saying? What a load of absolute horseshit.
Oh, horseshit. Horseshit. Let's all say horseshit. Say horseshit, Bill.
He's fucking one of his students. It's pretty uncool, if you ask me. Some people would think that's cool, like those dicks that teach with them in the humanities department, because they're all fucking their students, or wish they were fucking their students. Lolita. I mean, I don't care and all. He can fuck whoever he wants, and that's who teachers meet students. He was just a turd. The way I went about with Mom. Not giving her a chance to respond or anything. What sucks now is that Mom is watching me like a hawk. Like she's afraid I'm gonna have some sort of post-divorce freakout and shoot up the school or do heroin or, God forbid, lose my virginity. You know, I don't know what it is about dad splitting that put Mom on hymen control. Do you have a boyfriend?
No, not these days.
Me either. I did go out with this boy Josh for like almost a year, but he was retarded. Are your parents still together?
They passed away.
Oh, I'm sorry.
It's okay. Thank you.
Oh. Fuck, no, I'm sorry. I feel fucking terrible now.
It's okay, really.
Oh God, okay, were you close?
Yeah.
Another stupid question there, Jean. Real nice. Are you close with your parents?
Not everybody is.
Yeah, right, so that's what I meant. Thanks. Oh, this is them.
It's the wedding picture.
Oh, that's sweet. Their costumes are fantastic. This is a great room. Very Night of the Hunter. You know, this is where I used to stay whenever Mom and Dad would come visit.
I'm sorry.
Doesn't matter to me, it's just a room. What's your name?
T.S. Eliot.
That's cool.
Your grandfather wanted to me.
Grandpa's weird. Mom freaked when she got the call from Aunt Ivy this morning. Just like, freaked. It was weird. I'd never seen her like that. I mean, I guess it's not weird that she freaked out, but like, to see your mom freak like that, like you've never seen before, you know? And we're real close. Do you ever see your parents freak out?
They weren't really good times.
Yeah, right? So like, imagine if you did, just one day see them totally lose their shit. Just like, whoa! I like your necklace.
Thank you.
Is this a turtle?
Mm-hmm.
Did you make this?
My grandmother.
Feels like there's something in it.
My umbilical cord.
Ew, are you serious?
Yes.
Oh my God, that's kind of gross.
It's not insanitary.
Why would you do that?
It's some kind of Cheyenne tradition.
You're Cheyenne. Look at that movie, Powwow Highway. Did you see that?
When a Cheyenne baby is born, their umbilical cord is dried and sewn into this patch. Turtles for girls and lizards for boys. And we wear it for the rest of our lives.
Wow.
Because if we lose it, our souls belong nowhere. And after we die, our souls will search the earth looking for where they belong.
Don't tell anybody about Mom and Dad splitting up, okay? They're trying to play this kind of low-key.
Hey, look what I found. Isn't this great?
We have copies.
I didn't remember there was a hardback edition. I didn't think I remember when they published poetry in hardback. No, I don't think I remember when they published poetry at all.
I'm not going to be able to sleep and just eat.
Oh, man, this was a big deal.
It wasn't that big a deal.
In those circles it was.
Those are small circles.
Dedicated to my violin. But isn't that nice? You know, I can't imagine what must have been going through his head when he wrote this. The pressure he must have been going under. I mean, every word that he wrote, he had to be thinking. What are they going to say about this? Are they going to compare this to memoir?
Did Jean go to bed?
Yeah, she just went upstairs. Turn off the lights. You know, I don't know, but it seems like at a certain point you would just have to say the hell with it and write whatever you want anyway. And who cares what anybody else
thinks?
Will
you please shut up about that fucking book?
What's the matter?
You are just dripping with envy over these 30 poems my father wrote back in the fucking 60s. For God's sakes, don't you hear yourself?
You're mistaken. I have great admiration for these poems, not envy.
Citing his list of awards.
I was merely speaking about the value.
My father didn't write anymore for a lot of reasons, but critical opinion was not one of them. As hard as that may be for you to believe, I know how important that stuff is to you.
Why are you attacking me? I mean, I haven't done anything to you.
Oh, I'm sure that's what you tell Sissy, too, so she can come.
comfort you, reassure you. No, Billy, you haven't done anything.
Why are you even bringing that up? I mean, what does that have to do with anything?
They're all just symptoms of your male menopause. Whether it's you struggling with the creative question or screwing a girl who still wears a retainer.
Look, I came here to be with you because I wanted to be with you during a difficult time. But I refuse to be held hostage in this room so that you can attack me.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to hold you hostage. You really should go then.
Oh no. Oh no, I'm staying right here. I flew out to Oklahoma to be here with you and now you're stuck with me. Oh, and her name is Cindy.
I know her stupid name. At least you need the courtesy of recognizing when I was meeting you.
You know, Violet really has a way of bringing out the attack mode in you, you know?
She doesn't have anything to do with it.
Oh, don't you believe it. You have such hatred for you inside of you that you can't help but dish it out in my direction.
You psychoanalyze me right now? I skinned you.
You might not agree with my methods, but you know I'm right.
Your methods? Thank you, Doctor. But I don't need any help from my mother to feel rage.
Oh, okay. You want to argue? Is that what you want to do? All right, I'll tell you what. You pick a subject and you stick to it, so at least I have a fighting chance.
I am the subject. The subject is me, you narcissistic motherfucker. I am in pain. I need help.
I've caught to being a narcissist. We come from a narcissistic generation.
You can't do it, can you? You can't talk about me for 2 seconds.
You call me a narcissist. And when I talk about you, you accuse me of psychoanalyzing you.
Do men really believe that here and now is enough? It's just horseshit to avoid talking about the things they're afraid to say.
Look, I'm not necessarily keen on the notion of saying things that would upset you.
Like what?
Don't.
What? Surely you must know there's nothing you can say to me that can hurt me any worse than I've already hurt it.
You know,
damage is done.
I think you're wrong. You know, I think that you get into this masochistic frame of mind where you desire to be hurt more than anything.
What?
Look, we've got enough on our hands right now with your parents, okay? This is not a time to revisit all of this.
Revisit? When did we visit this in the first place? You pulled the rug out from under me. I still don't know what happened. Do I bore you? Intimidate you? Disgust you? Is this just about the pleasures of teenage flesh? Young pussy? I really need to know.
You need to know now. You need to know right now. With Beverly missing, your mother is crazy for losing your daughter just 20 feet away. You really need to know this now.
No. I'll just hunker down for a cozy night's sleep next to my husband.
Look, this discussion deserves our patience and our care. We'll be in a much better frame of mind to discuss this after your father comes home.
My father's dead, Bill.
Excuse me, it's Jonna.
What is it?
Excuse me.
What?
The sheriff is here.
Turn on the lights.
The sheriff is here. Should I wake Mrs. Weston?
I don't know, Bill.
Yeah, you better get her up.
What's going on?
Go back to bed, honey.
What?
The sheriff is here. Please go back to bed.
Why are the police here?
I don't know, honey. Please go back to bed.
Mrs. Weston! Mrs. Weston!
Mom! Mom, wake up! Wake up! The sheriff is here!
Did you call them?
No.
I didn't call them.
Mom, you need to wake up and come downstairs. The sheriff is here.
In an Esther and broken throat.
Come on!
What?
Just come on. Just leave her there. Bill Ford, Barbara's husband.
Hi, Barbara.
Oh, my God, I know you. Oh, my God. Dan!
Yes, ma'am. I'm afraid I have some bad news for you folks.
Okay.
We found your father. He's dead.
Oh, dear God.
I am sorry.
What happened?
Well, we got a call a few hours ago. Lake Patrol found Mr. Weston's boat stranded on a sandbar, and we were about to drag that corner of the lake to southeast when we got another call. Apparently some old boys were running some jug lines in the cove, and they hooked Mr. Weston and pulled him up.
Now? I mean, this time of night?
Well, these boys were on those lines earlier.
So he drowned, that's how he died? Drowning?
Yes, sir.
But, sir, any way to tell, I mean, if maybe it wasn't him?
Well, considering the proximity of the boat to where the body was found, we're pretty sure it's Mr. Weston.
All right, okay, so what do we do now? What happens now?
Well, I need a family member to come and positively identify the body.
To your station house?
No, sir. He's still at the lake.
I don't think I can do this.
Look, I'll go. Can I do it? Can I go?
It needs to be a blood relative, but if I was the one to go, I suggest you come along as well.
No, I can't do it.
I'm sorry, honey. What choice do we have?
Well, I can do it. I'm a blood relative.
No, I'll go. I will.
Okay, can you give us a few minutes?
Yes, sir. Barbara, I am sorry. You know, this is the hardest part of my job, and not what, to do it for somebody that you know of. I mean, I'm really sorry.
What do you want to do about your mother?
I, fuck it. Fuck it.
Right.
I'll go change my clothes.
I'll be right out. Jean, go help your mother, all right? Look, I'm sorry to ask this, but is there any way, I mean, do they think it's an accident or suicide?
Well, it's really hard to tell.
Okay, well, what are you thinking? I mean, what are your thoughts?
Suicide. My guess would be suicide, but the official cause of death is drowning, and that's the end of it.
I understand.
Now, I must warn you, the body has been in the water for all 3 days.
Right.
And so I'll need you to prepare your wife if you can.
Prepare?
What happens to a body is it's all bloated, it's an ugly color, and, well, the fish have eaten the eye.
Oh, shit. Look, how does a person jump into the water and just choose not to swim?
Well, I don't think you do unless you really mean business.
Choose not to swim?
Yes, sir.
I'm sorry. Can you have a seat? I'll be just a few minutes, okay? Get ready.
What about me, I do?
Oh, I don't know. I guess we'll stop there on our way back. Christ, I need to call Karen, too.
The
fuck am I brushing my hair for? I used to go out with that boy. With that man.
What man?
The sheriff. He was my prom date.
You're kidding.
The day of prom, his father stole his car. Stole his own son's car and drove it to somewhere, I don't know, Mexico. Dan showed up wearing this awful tuxedo. He'd been crying, I could tell. He had to confess he didn't have a way to get to the prom. So I told him we'd walk about 3 miles. We got so sweaty and dirty and broke a heel. We got a six-pack and busted into the chapel and stayed up all night talking and kissing. And now he's here telling me, God, it's just so surreal. Do me a favor. Die after me, all right? I don't care what you do, where you go, how you screw up your life. Just die after me, all right?
I'll do my best.
Harry, you ready?
Give me a second.
How's the story?
Violet.
Barely back?
I beg your pardon.
Did some barely come home?
Ma'am?
He's the same that the
August, your month, locusts all raging. Summer song becomes summer wrath. Of course, it's only August out there. In here, who knows? All right, okay. The carriage held but just ourselves. Dum-dee-dum. Best I got. Emily Dickinson's all I got. Horse's head towards eternity. One for me. pain to my body. Put that one in marble. For the girls. All I can dedicate to you, sir, is that. Other than that, not one thing. No thing. Do you think I'll eat for you? Do you think I'll play the part like we played the others? You made your choice. You made this happen. You answer for this. Not me. Not me. This is not mine.
Chamber of Commerce guy.
10 years older than me, but a thinker, someone who's been around. He's just so good, and he's good to me, and he's good for me.
That's great, Karen.
And he's got this great business, and it's because he has all these great ideas, and he's unafraid to make his ideas realities. He's not afraid of just jumping in and doing. I think men on the whole are better at that than women, don't you? Just jumping in and doing. Right or wrong, we'll figure out what it all means later. And the best thing about him, the best thing about him for me, is that now, what I think about is now. I live now. My life, my focus, my world is now. I don't give a care about the past anymore. The mistakes I made, the way I thought it, I won't go back there. And I realize that you can't plan for the future either, because as soon as you do, something happens. Something terrible happens.
Like your father killing himself?
Exactly! Exactly! That's exactly what I mean! That's not something you can plan for. There's no contingency. You just take it as it comes. Here and now. Steve had this very important business plan, something he'd been planning for months with a bunch of Pickwick government guys. They were going to have this meeting and it was going to be really important for his business. But as soon as we got the call about Daddy, he called and canceled. He had his priorities straight. Do you know what the kicker is? Do you know what the kicker is?
What's the kicker?
We're going to believe on our honeymoon!
Sorry, hot flash.
I didn't even tell him about my little Belize fantasy. He just up and surprised me with tickets for after the wedding.
That smells good. What are we having?
Fried chicken, mashed potatoes, green bean casserole, and greens.
Did Maddie Faye make her green bean casserole?
Oh, I don't know. Should I not have made it?
No, it's good that you did. Hers is inedible.
I mean, can you believe it about Belize?
That's terrific.
I know you only just met him. Did you get a read off of him? Do you like him?
Said two words to each other.
I know, but you still get a feel, don't you? Did you get a feel?
Well, he seemed very nice, sweetheart.
He is.
But I'm not the one marrying him, so it doesn't matter.
You will come to the wedding, won't you?
Yeah, when is it?
New Year's Day? One of the reasons we chose New Year's Day is because I know you and Bill will have time off from school, and it's very important to me that you be there.
Okay, it's in Sarasota, right?
Miami! Didn't you know I moved to Miami?
Yes, that's right.
That's where Steve's business is.
Right, right.
Anyway, what I'm trying to tell you is that I'm finally happy. I've been unhappy for most of my life, or my adult life. And I doubt you realize that because I know that life has pulled us apart, me and Ivy, and we're not as close as most, we're not as close as we.
Yes. We need to talk about mom. What to do about mom.
But I think one of the reasons for that is because I haven't wanted to live my unhappiness in full view of my family. Now, I'm finally happy. And I'm really hoping that we can get to know each other a little bit better.
Okay. Okay. Oh, Christ, where are they with the wine?
There's another example. Steve doesn't know a soul here, but he got right in the car with Bill and Jean to go get wine. He's family. I really don't want to.
Oh, it wouldn't kill you to try this on.
Well, this is a sweet one, Bob.
I find this all a tinge morbid, quite frankly.
What's morbid about it?
And I'm not really prepared to look at these photographs right now.
This is a beautiful dress. It's very modern.
It's such a style, Mom.
You don't have a style. That's the whole point.
Guys.
New York, first book tour, New York City.
You mean I don't have your style? I have a style of
my own. New York City, 1964.
You wore a suit to your father's funeral. A woman doesn't wear a suit to a funeral.
No, you're weird. It's a black suit.
You look like a magician's assistant.
Oh, you know.
Speaking about moving to New York City.
Why do you feel it necessary to
start now?
Why do you feel it necessary?
Last day in that city, they tear him
apart. Why do you feel it necessary to insult?
Stop being sensitive.
years old, and he overslept for my brother-in-law's funeral. A new service.
Well, I'm sure there's more to the story than that.
Don't make excuses for him. That's what Charlie always says. It's always done. It's just like, oh, he overslept. La-di-da. I'll go pick him up at the bus station.
You are so hard on him.
Well, the boy is 37 years old and can't drive.
He's a little different, I'll give you that.
I think you're a little bit
I mean, who can't drive?
I don't think you're very understanding.
I've seen a champ drive.
Would you just take off that cheap suit and try this on?
Cheap? Did you just call this cheap?
And what about this one?
No, that's the going on the sideboard, so it has to be something that we easily recognize.
Oh, you need something big.
Oh, I got a
friend. This is the most expensive item of clothing that I own.
Well, I don't see what difference it makes how expensive something it is. I mean, a suit of armor is expensive if it doesn't make it appropriate.
Well, this is a big one, but it's of the two of you.
Why are you trying to get rid of all your clothes?
Do you mind if it's
a clothes? Oh, I'm getting rid of a lot of this stuff. I'm downgrading.
Downgrading?
Downsizing.
What about this?
No, I'm serious. I'm getting rid of all this shit. I want all that stuff in the office gone. I want this clothes that I'm never going to wear anymore gone. I want it all gone. I mean, come on. Just look at these fucking shoes. Can you picture me in these? I mean, even if I don't fall on my face, can you imagine anything less attractive than my varicose veins and swollen ankles? Oh, and my toenails. Ooh, look, any more than I can dig through cement.
Is this the idea?
Oh, look at me. You're
beautiful, Mom.
Oh, that's beautiful. Not yours.
Oh, now.
You're so beautiful.
No, that's one of those lies we tell ourselves to give us comfort. Women are beautiful when they're young, not after. Now, men, they can preserve their sex appeal well into the old age. Now, I'm not talking about those guys with the shorts and the little purses around their waist. Now, some men, they can maintain if they embrace it. And, you know, their cragginess, their weary masculinity. Women, they just get old, fat, and wrinkly.
Hey, I beg your pardon.
Just think about what makes a young girl sexy. Think about the last time that you saw some young girl at the mall and you said, well, she's a cute gal. What makes her that way?
Taut skin, firm boobs, and an ass above her knees.
Hey, I'm still very sexy, thank you very much.
You are about as sexy as a wet cardboard box man. Hey, no, no, you and me, no.
Just stop fooling yourself. We should all just stop fooling ourselves. Isn't it time we started stop lying to ourselves and just told the truth for a change? Women aren't sexy when they get old. I can live with that.
Can you live with that?
I can live with it, but I disagree. What about some yellow around her? Mm-hmm. Or what about Lena Horne? She stayed sexy way until her 80s.
The world is round. Get over it. Would you just try on this dress?
I'm sorry, I won't.
I mean...
Okay, here is getting just stupid now.
You don't know how to attract a man. That is something that I...
It's a funeral. We just buried my father. I'm not trying to attract a man.
I'm not talking about today, dummy. This dress you...
I have a man, all right? I have a man.
You told me you weren't looking for a man.
And I'm not. Because I have one. Okay, now give me a little love.
Oh! Please tell me it's not Mr. Barry.
Oh, no, it isn't Barry.
Like, please tell us something. Is he young? Or does he go to school?
I am not telling you anything either of you, so you might
as well. You have to tell us something.
No,
come on.
I really don't.
Oh, are you in love, Abby?
Love? But love is just a word.
No, we mainly handle account offshore, just until we get approvals.
Get around approvals?
Get around approvals until we get approvals. I mean, there's a lot of red tape, a lot of bureaucracy. I'm not exactly sure how much you know about Florida. Well, Florida politics, that is.
Only when I read, well, that's not a whole lot.
You're right. And this job in particular.
Could you remind me again what that job is? I think I forgot.
It's essentially security. The situation in the Middle East is a perpetuously dangerous, and there's a tremendous amount of money.
Security work, being a mercenary.
Yeah,
give me the wine.
I like to think of more as a missionary than mercenary.
Is this what you were in such a hurry to get home for?
Yeah.
What the hell is on TV that is so important?
And with the opera 1925, Blonde Chain.
Oh, no kidding, cool.
Christ, Gene, you can rent it at any video store.
Well, no, but they're showing with the scene in color of a store.
Oh, really? What is the scene again, sweetheart? Just the mess ball, right? All right.
Let me get this straight. When you threw a fit about going to the store with your father, hey, look at me. And you were so very distraught over the start time of your grandpa's funeral. Was this your concern? Getting home in time to watch the Phantom of the fucking Opera?
I guess.
I'll take these into the kitchen.
Oh, I've got them.
Movie buff, huh?
Yeah.
Right. Me too. You ever seen this one?
Mm-hmm.
Oh. Really good. Apparently Chaney had designed his own makeup.
I know.
Yeah. Apparently very painful. Yeah. He took fishing one night. She helped underneath his nose.
Yeah. I know.
Have you ever seen any of the remakes?
I've seen the one with Claude Rains.
Right. It's pretty bad. Phantom of Queer, you know. That's a problem.
I don't remember it so much. I was just a kid.
Well, yeah. Well, I guess you're not getting more, I guess.
What?
I say, you're not getting anymore.
No. I mean, yeah.
Well, how old are you? What? 17?
15.
15, yeah, that's no kid. You're no kid. Hey, you know what I was doing when I was your age?
What?
Cattle processing. You know what that is?
It doesn't sound good.
Slaughterhouse. Sanitation. Slaughterhouse sanitation.
That's disgusting.
Yeah. I don't recommend it, but hey, they put food on the table. Get it? Well, wait a minute. What's that smell?
Oh, food. From the kitchen?
No, that's not what I'm smelling.
What are you doing?
Do I smell what I think I smell?
What do you think you smell?
What do you think I smell?
I think you smell food from the kitchen.
Yes, it can.
What are you doing?
Is that pot?
Oh, I don't know.
Are you smoking pot?
No.
Come on, you can tell me.
No.
Okay. Is it just me, or is it getting hot in here?
It's hot.
You're hot?
Yeah.
How hot are you?
Really hot.
Really hot?
Yeah.
Yeah, you are a little dipper smoker, you. Well, you just happen to be in luck because I just happen to have some really tasty shit. It's because I just happen to have some really good nuggets. I'm going to you up.
That would be great because I just smoked my last ball and I really need to get fucked up.
You need to what?
Get fucked up.
You need to get what?
Fucked up.
Wait, you need to get fucked up what?
You're bad.
I'm just goofing with you. Hi, sweetheart.
What you doing?
I'm just goofing here with your niece.
I think we're getting ready to eat.
Oh, great. I'm starving.
Did you remember to get the cigarettes?
Dang it. Didn't I write that you lounge getting? I'm sorry. I didn't know I should get something.
I have to rock with Mama.
Oh, I have cigarettes.
You have cigarettes.
Mama lights.
I think she's got a ring.
Jean, honey, you're too young to smoke.
Yeah.
You know, don't encourage her.
Hey, she's no kid.
Could we borrow a couple of cigarettes? Yep.
Hey, we're not supposed to encourage you.
Hush.
Thanks, doll. Now, stop smoking. Hi, Dino.
Hi,
sweetheart. Hi, Dino. Ooh, come on back. I want to show your old fort. Man, the air in here just doesn't move.
I'm sorry, Dad. Stop apologizing to me. Hold on a second.
set the alarm. I did.
I know you did.
I wanted to be there.
Well, you're here now.
I love Uncle Bev. You know that.
Stop apologizing.
The power must have gone out. I woke up and the clock was blinking noon. That means the power went out, right?
Yeah, it's okay.
I missed his funeral!
It's a ceremony. It's ceremonial. It doesn't mean anything compared to what you have in your heart.
Uncle Bev must be so disappointed at me.
Oh, your Uncle Bev's got bigger and better things ahead of him. He doesn't have time for spite. Besides, he wasn't that sort of man, anyway. Hey, little child. Hey. Hey, it's okay. It's okay, man.
It's just, I know how things are. I know how they feel about me. And when something like this happens, and you just want to be there for people, and I missed his funeral, and I know how they feel about me.
Ooh, how who feels about? Feels what about you?
Them, all of them. I know what they say.
They don't say anything about you.
I see how they are, and I don't blame them. I'm sorry I disappointed you, Dad.
Hey, now. You didn't disappoint me. Never disappoint me. Now, listen. You're wrong about these people. They love you. Some of them haven't had a chance to see what I see. A fine man. Very lovely. A lot to offer. Come here. Take this. Remember coming back. Now, look people in the eye. Stand up straight. And stop being so hard on yourself.
I love you, Dad.
You are compassionate, but you are hard.
You are thoughtful, but you are not old. You are a warm, decent, funny, wonderful woman. And I do love you. But you're a pain in the ass!
Dinner's ready!
Oh, look who decided to show up. Sorry to wake you, sweetheart.
I'm sorry, Mama.
Oh,
I'm serious. You say anything.
He's here now. That's all that matters.
He has nothing to say to this little mom.
He's the patriarch around here now.
Sure.
I am.
I guess I am.
By law.
Okay. Dear Lord, we ask that you watch over this family at this sad time, Lord, and that you bless this good woman and keep her in your grace.
I've got to take this.
We ask that you watch over Beverly too, as she as he makes his journey. We are thankful, Lord, that we can gather here together to pay tribute to this fine man. In his house, with his beautiful family, and his three beautiful daughters, we are truly blessed in our fellowship, our togetherness, our fellowship. We thank thee, O Lord, for this food which we can share and replenish our bodies with nourishment. We ask thee, O Lord, that you help us to get better, be better people. We realize now, more than ever, the power and the joy of family. And we ask that you watch over and bless this family. Amen.
Amen.
Let's see.
Amen. Sorry about that, guys.
Bob, you're interested in that sideboard. Mm-hmm. Would you like to have that sideboard?
Well, this one, no, I need why.
Well, I can't bring a lot of this stuff, and I thought you might like that sideboard.
Well, no, Mom, I wouldn't have any way to get that back to Boulder. It's really pretty.
Maybe I won't take it.
Oh, no, I have something like that. Remember from the
market? What are you getting rid of?
Oh, all this stuff. I want a brand new everything.
I guess I'm just not ready to get rid of your stuff.
Suit yourself.
This food is very delicious.
Mm-hmm. Yes, good.
Yeah. Do you like your food, Mom?
I really haven't had much of it.
Jonna cooked this whole meal by herself.
What?
I said, Jonna cooked this whole meal by herself.
It's what she's paid for. You all do know she's getting paid, right?
So Jean, I'm curious. When you say you don't eat meat,
uh-huh.
Yep. Do you mean that you don't eat meat of any kind?
Right. No, she.
And is that for health reasons or?
Well, when you eat meat, you ingest an animal's fear.
You ingest what? It's fur?
No, it's fear.
Fear? How do you do that? You can't eat fear.
Well, sure you can. I mean, even if you don't think of it sort of spiritually, what happens to you when you feel afraid? Doesn't your body produce all of these chemical reactions?
It does.
Yes. Your body goes through this whole chemical process when it experiences fear. Particularly like strong mortal fear. You know, when your palms start to sweat and your heart races.
There's like adrenaline and cortisol.
Okay, sure.
Well, don't you think an animal experiences fear?
That does.
So, when you eat meat, you're eating all of the fear the animal felt when it was slaughtered to make food.
Wow.
Right. I actually used to work in a processing factory. There's a lot of fear going around that place.
So, tell me, I've been eating fear, what, 3 times a day for 60 years?
Yeah, this one doesn't think he's had a meal unless there's meat in it.
Well, maybe it's the way I was raised, but It just doesn't seem to be a legitimate meal without meat in it somewhere.
Well, you know, if I make a pasta dish, he's like, whoa, that was a great appetizer, but where's the meat?
Where's the meat? Isn't that that commercial with the old lady? And she says, where's the meat?
Beef. Where's the beef?
Where's the meat? Where's the meat? Where's the meat?
I sure thought the services were in love.
Yes, they were, weren't they?
The preacher did a fine
job. I give it a
Really? Great. So now we get some dramatic criticism.
I would prefer an open casket.
That just wasn't possible, Mom.
That there was the service that Beverly would have had if he died in, say, 1974. All that talk about poetry and teaching. Well, he hasn't written any poetry since 1965, and he didn't care for teaching worth a damn. Nobody talked about the good stuff. That man was a world-class alcoholic more than 50 years. Nobody gave that story about that time he got wrangled into giving that TU alumni's talk. Oh my God, he drank a whole bottle of rum. Ron McCoy, white rum. I don't know why I remember that. Well, anyway, he got up to give that talk, and then he found himself. Oh, he went back to the table, and he had a view.
Yeah, I can't imagine why no one told that story.
Oh, he didn't get invited back to any more alumni dinner. That, I'll tell you that much.
Your father here,
he made some good investments, if you might believe it, and he had to go
girl's taken care of. Well, after some time passed, we talked about it, and we decided to change things and leave everything to me. Now, of course, we didn't get around it legally, but you should know we meant to leave everything to me, leave the money to me.
Okay.
Karen, okay?
Okay.
Now some of this stuff, like this furniture, y'all can just have it. I don't need it. I have no use for it. Ooh, maybe I should have an auction.
Sure, an auction's a fine idea.
Now some of this stuff, like the silverware, this is worth a pretty penny. Well, if you like, I'll give it to you cheaper than you might get at an auction.
Or maybe you'll never get around to the auction, and we can just have it for free after you die.
You might have that.
Excuse me, Bill. These are right.
Hey, Bill, where are you living now? You interested in that sideboard?
I beg your pardon?
Well, you and Barbara separated, right? Or are you divorced already?
We're separated.
You thought you were slipping that one by me, didn't you?
What is the matter with you?
Nobody slips anything by me. I don't know what's what. I mean, your father, he thought he was slipping one by me. No way. Now, you know, it's hard to explain, but you really just can't compete with a younger woman. Is there a younger woman involved?
I think you've said enough on the subject.
Yes, there's a younger woman.
Oh, you see, the odds are against you, babe.
Mom believes that women don't grow more attractive with age.
I
disagree.
I didn't say they don't grow more attractive. I said they get ugly. And you know, it's really not a matter of debate, Karen, dear, because you're only just starting to show it yourself.
You're in rare form today, Vi.
The day calls for it. What form would you rather me be in?
I just don't understand why you have to be so adversarial.
Well, I'm just truth-telling. Some people get antagonized by the truth.
Everyone loves you here, dear.
Are you trying to shame me, Charlie? Blow it at your ass!
I had to identify my father's corpse 3 days ago, and now I sit here and listen to you viciously attack each and every member of this family.
Attack your family? Have you ever been attacked in your sweet, spoiled life? Tell them about attacks, Mad Faye. Tell them what an attack feels like.
Please.
Mom, settle down.
Quit telling me to settle down, goddammit! Goddamn invalid! Am I supposed to be abiding? Am I already passed over? This woman, she came to my rescue when one of my dear mother's many gentlemen friends was attacking me with a clawed hammer! This woman has dents in her skull from hammer blows! And you think you've been attacked? What do you know about life on these plains? What do you know about hard times? You don't know! You do not know! The only one who knows is this woman right here, and that man that we buried today! Sweet Barbara, sweet girl, my heart aches. It aches for every time that you ever felt pain. I wish I could shield you from it. What did you think? For a single, solitary second, that you can fathom the amount of pain that your father endured in his natural life, you gotta know the thing coming. Do you know where your father lived from the age of 4 till about 10? Do you? Do you?
No.
No.
In a Pontiac accident with his mama and his father. Tell me about your rotten childhood. Oh, that's the crux of this, isn't it? We lived too hard, and we rose too high. We sacrificed everything, and we did it all for you! You girls were given a college education.
no doubt.
And where did you wind up?
What do you do? What do you do?
Who are you?
You all worked as hard as us, you'd all be president.
You ain't never had a real problem in your life, so you gotta go and make all your problems yourself.
Why are you yelling at us?
I'm just truth telling. It's just a damn fine day to tell the truth.
Well, truth is, I'm getting full.
Amen.
And there's dessert, too.
I saw her making those pies earlier. They look delicious.
I have a truth.
It's fake.
No, no.
What is it, son?
I have a truth.
Please not like this, please.
The truth is the power didn't go out. I forgot to set the alarm. I'm sorry I disappointed you, Mom. I'm sorry, everybody. Excuse me.
Scintillating.
Oh, I give up on him. Little Charles is your project.
Charles! His name is Charles.
Oh, poor Abby. Poor my babies, Mama.
Oh, poor girl.
Please.
She's always had a thing for the underdog.
Don't be mean to me right now, okay?
Now, why does everybody think that I'm mean all of a sudden?
Please, Mama.
I'm just telling the truth.
You're a drug addict.
That is right. That's the truth. I am a drug addict. I am addicted to pills, downers. See these little babies? They are my best fucking friends. You try to take them away from me and I will eat you alive.
Give me the fucking pill.
She goes to the doctor for back spasms and he writes her a prescription. Day or two later, she says she loses her pills, so he writes her another one. Then the next week, she pulls a muscle, more pills, then the dosage is wrong, more pills, over and over, until finally she makes one too many trips, and he says, I'm not prescribing you anymore. Then she takes a sheet of prescription receipts out of the purse and says, I'll go to the AMA and have your ass in court for overprescribing me. She genuinely threatens these men, and they give in to her.
You knew this was going on again? Different tactic today. Just at her wounded best, this wilting hothouse flower, which made me look like Betty Davis. I tried to motor into it, you know. Come on, Mom. Give him a speech about the greatest generation. Tell him about Claudia. I was like that guy in the cartoon with the frog that only sings for him.
Oh, it wouldn't have done any good. Dr. Burke's part of that same generation.
Greatest generation, my ass. I mean, are they really considering all the generations? I mean, maybe there was a generation during the Iron Age. And what makes them so great anyway? Because they were poor and hated Nazis? Who doesn't fucking hate Nazis? Remember that stunt she pulled when we checked her into the psych ward?
Oh, which time?
Oh, big speech. She's getting clean. This huge sacrifice she's making for her family.
Oh, right. She's let her family down and she wants to prove that she's a good family member.
She smuggled a bottle of Thermoset into the psych ward. In her vagina.
Oh!
Here's the greatest generation for you. She gave us this huge speech while she was clenching a bottle of pills in her cooch.
God, I never heard that story
before.
Cooch? Did you just say cooch?
A phrase mom's pussy seems to think.
Oh, you're a little bit more comfortable with cooch, are you?
What word should I use to describe our mother's vagina?
I don't know, but.
Mom's beaver.
What
the hell are you going to do in New York?
We have plans.
Like what?
Which is what?
Understanding.
What about Mom?
What about her?
You feel comfortable leaving her here.
Do you? You think she was difficult while Dad was around?
Oh, think about what it's going to be like now. You can't imagine the cumulative effect. After a month, after a year, after many years, you can't imagine. And even if you could, you can only imagine for yourself. For yourself, the favorite.
Christ. Mom pulled that one on me the other day about Dad, that I was his favorite.
Oh, well, that's not true. You weren't Dad's favorite. I was your mom's favorite.
Oh, what?
Thanks, Ivy.
Oh, good God. What, are you going to think so? I lived my life by that standard.
Mom said Dad was heartbroken when we went to Boulder.
Mom was heartbroken. She was convinced that you moved to get away from her.
If you're Daddy's favorite, you must be taking the suicide kind of personally. Mm.
Daddy killed himself for his own reasons.
And what were those reasons?
I don't presume.
Aren't you angry with him?
No. He's accountable to no one but himself. If he's better off now, and I don't doubt that he is, who won't be his regression back?
His daughters!
Yeah.
And I'm fucking furious, the selfish son of a bitch! With his silence, his melancholy, he could have for me. For us. For all of us. He could have talked to us. Included us.
You might not have liked what you heard. What if the fact of the matter is that Beverly Weston never liked you? That he never liked any of us, that he never had any special feeling of any kind for his children?
You know that's not true.
Do I? How? Do you?
You said you were his favorite.
Only because he recognized a kindred spirit.
I'm sorry, but your little theory, your random genetics, that doesn't fly. Not with me. I believe he had a responsibility to something greater than himself. We all do.
Good luck with that. I just can't believe your worldview is that dark.
You live in Florida.
When are you leaving?
Weeks, if not days.
Are you going to tell Mom?
I'm still trying to figure that out.
What about your job, your house?
I have been taking care of myself a lot longer than you've been in charge. Here, you go back to Miami, right?
Yes.
There you go, Barb.
You want to know what we're going to do about Mom?
Karen and I are leaving. If you want to stay here and deal with her, that is your decision. And if you don't like it, that's your prerogative. But nobody gets to point a finger at me. Nobody.
Hello? Am I interrupting?
You had a bath?
Mm-hmm.
Did you want something to eat or drink? Do you want some coffee?
No, I'm fine. I'm fine. Oh, you girls. All here together. Just hearing the voices outside that door gives me a warm feeling. These walls must have heard some secrets.
I get embarrassed just thinking about it.
Oh. Nothing to be embarrassed about. Secret crushes and secret schemes. The province of a teenage girl. I can't think of anything more delicate or bittersweet.
Oh, that's so good. Doesn't it? It's that way. You want some?
Oh, yes, please. Have I ever told you girls a story about raining walls? Not really, there's not much story to it. He was a boy that I had a crush on when I was about 12 or 13. Real tough looking boy. He had these beat up Levi's and messy hair and this horrible underbite. Oh, but he had these beautiful cowboy boots. They were shiny chocolate leather. And he was so proud of his boots. You could tell by his all swinging arms and elbows puffed up and cocksure. Mm. Well, I convinced myself that I needed a girly pair of those very same boots. I convinced myself that if he saw me in them, he would want to go steady with me. And I found those boots. I found them in a store window. I stayed up late at night praying what I would say to him when he saw me in those boots. Oh, I must ask my mama 100 times if I could have those boots. Oh, Val, what do you want for Christmas? Mama, I would give it all up if I could just have those boots. You know, bargaining, you know. And then Mama started dropping some hints
about a present under the tree box size of a blue box, really nice wrapping paper. She said, "Now why don't you cheat and start looking under that tree?" Well, Christmas came, and I was out like a shot. I was under that tree. I was ripping off that wrapping paper. And there was a pair of boots, all right. Men's work boots. Torn up toes. Chewed up laces. Caked in mud and dog shit. My mama must have laughed at this.
Please don't tell me that's the end of the story.
No, that's it. You ever got the boots? No, uh-uh.
Well, that is the worst story I have ever heard. That leaves me wishing for a heartwarming clawhammer story.
Well, my mama was a mean, nasty old lady. I guess that's where I get it from.
You're
not
going to
be nasty. You're
a
mama. We love you.
Thank you, sweetheart. Hey, y'all. I need to talk to Mom for a minute. How's your head?
Fine.
I'm sorry. I lost my temper and I went too far.
Barbara, the day of the funeral, the pills, I was just spoiling for a fight. And you gave it to me.
So, truce?
Truce.
So, what do you want to do now?
What do you mean?
I mean, don't you think you should check into a rehab facility?
Oh, no. I can't do that. I can do this. I'm pretty sure I can do this.
Really?
Well, the pills are gone, right?
All we can find.
I don't have that many hiding places.
Please.
Do you want to search me?
No.
Look, if the pills are gone, it'll just take me a few days to get my feet from under me.
Like for you right now. I just want you to know you're not alone in this. What can I do to help?
I need help.
I want to help.
I don't need your help.
Mom.
I don't need your help. I have been through the... I know how this is. Once all the talking is done, everybody goes back to their own nonsense. I know that. Stop worrying about me. I can manage. I'll get by.
Is the coast clear?
Never very.
What are you watching?
Just in television.
Can I watch it with you?
Wish you would. I almost blew it, didn't I?
Yep.
Are you mad at me?
Nope.
I was just trying to be brave.
I know.
I just wanted everyone to know that I got what I always wanted and that I'm now a loser.
You're my hero.
Come here, you can help me.
Thank you.
dogs.
Oh, well, because you know you're welcome.
Look, honey.
Little Charlie, how's the tea set on?
Oh, no, I was just...
This boy watches so much television, it's rotted his brain.
I'm sure that's not true.
What was that I caught you watching the other day?
I don't remember.
You two still remember. Some dang dumb game show about swapping wives.
I don't remember.
You do if you don't remember. Well, too bad they don't have pay you to sit around watching television.
Come on, Maddie Faye.
Suppose like you wouldn't like watching television if it constituted getting a job.
Maddie Faye, it's been a long day.
Did I tell you this boy got fired from a shoe store?
Maddie Faye, we're gonna get in the car now. We're gonna go home. And if you say one more mean thing to that boy, I'm gonna kick your fat Irish ass onto the highway. You hear me?
What the hell did you say?
Gibbs, go outside. I don't understand this meanness. I look at you and your sister and the way you talk to people and I don't understand it. I just don't understand why folks can't be respectful of one another. I don't think there's any excuse for it. My family didn't treat each other that way.
And that's because you're...
You had better not say anything about my family right now. I mean it. We buried a man today that I love very much. And whatever his faults were, he was a good, kind, decent person. And to hear you tearing your own son like that on a day like today dishonors Beverly's memory. We've been married for 38 years, and I wouldn't trade it for anything. But if you can't find a generous place in your heart for your own son, we're not going to make it to 39.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to eavesdrop. I froze.
That's, Barbara, do you have a cigarette?
Oh, no. I quit years ago.
So did I. It just sounded good to me. Barbara, that dinner today, that horrible dinner, seemed to me as if there was something...
What?
Seemed to me as if there might be something going on between Ivy and little Charles. Can you tell me if that's true?
This is gonna be kind of hard to explain. I mean,
just tell me if it's true.
Yes, it's true.
Well, no, that can't happen.
Well, I mean, I didn't know this was gonna be kind of hard to explain. I mean, little Charles have always marched to their own drummer, and I know this is gonna be hardest on you, and they think they're very much in love, or at least they think they are. I mean, what difference does it make, right? And I'm sure they're terrified of you and Mom, and I know it's pretty unorthodox for cousins to get together, at least these days, but it's not as uncommon as you might think.
Barbara, listen to me. They're not cousins.
Beg pardon?
Little Charles isn't your cousin. He's your brother. He's your blood brother. Little Charles isn't your cousin. He's your brother. Well, your half-brother. He's your father's son. That makes him Ivy's brother. Do you see? Little Charles and Ivy are brother and sister.
No. That's not. No. No!
Listen.
Go back in the kitchen.
Where's your father too?
Everybody, stay in the kitchen. No. It's... No! You and Dad.
Yes.
Who knows this?
You do and I do.
Uncle Charlie doesn't suspect.
We never discussed it.
What?
We never discussed it, okay?
Did Dad know?
You know I'm not proud of this.
What? Were you drunk? Was this just some sort of crazy animal?
No! I wasn't drunk!
No!
I know to you, I'm just your... this woman you've known for so many years. I'm just your old family, Maddie Faye. But there's more to me than that. There's much more to me than that. Charlie was right, of course. As usual. I don't know why little Charles
was such a disappointment to me. Maybe it's because, well, maybe I'm just disappointed for him. I made a mistake a long time ago, okay? I paid for it. The mistake has to end here. You have to stop it. You have to put a stop to this.
If Ivy found out about this, it would destroy her.
Well, I'm sure as hell not gonna tell her. You have to stop this. You have to be the one to stop this.
Why me?
You said you were handling things now.
Nothing happened here. God, can you please just not make a federal case out of everything? I couldn't.
What's the big deal?
The big deal, G, is that you're 14 years old.
You're just only a few years younger than you like him. I hate you!
Yeah? Well, I hate you too, you little freak!
G!
Let me go!
G! What is the matter with you?
Excuse me!
Can you do without the lecture? I beg your pardon? I'm leaving. We're leaving back to Florida tonight, now. Me and Steve together, you want to give me some kind of brief about that? No.
Karen.
You might want to find out from Dean what exactly went on in there, because I know she's exactly blameless in all this, so don't go pointing fingers without knowing.
Blaming her just because I said she's not blameless does not mean that I blame her. I'm just saying she might share the responsibility, you understand me?
I know Steve should have known better that she's only 14, but my point is that it's not cut and dry, black and white, good and bad. It lives where everything lives, somewhere in the middle, where everything lives and where everyone lives. Everyone except you.
Karen.
I'm not defending him. He's not perfect. Just like the rest of us down here in the mud. You know, I'm no angel myself. I've done some things I'm not proud of. Some things you'll never know about. You know what? I'll probably have to do some things I'm not proud of again. Because I'm only a human being after all. Anyway. You have your own hacks to settle before you go around making speeches to the rest of us.
Right.
Come January, I'll be in Belize. Doesn't that sound nice?
I'm taking Jean with me. We're heading back.
I...
Look, she's too much for you to handle right now.
Okay.
Oh, look, I know you're going to find some way to blame this all on me.
Yeah? Well, I fail. As a mother, as a sister, as a wife, I fail.
No, you don't.
Really? I attacked Jean and my mom within the span of about 9 hours. Stick around here much longer and I'll cut off your penis.
Hey, that's not fun.
Can't deal with Jean right now. She's just gonna have to wait until I get back to Boulder.
Look, you and Jean have 40 years to fight and make up.
Why? What happens in 40 years?
You die.
Oh, right.
If you're lucky.
No.
I mean, if we're lucky.
Says you. But you're never coming back to me, are you?
Never say never, but...
So no.
But no.
Even if things don't work out with you and Marcia?
Cindy.
Cindy.
Yes. Even if things don't work out.
I'm probably never going to understand why, am I?
Probably not.
I love you. I love you.
Sad.
something more hopeless than that. As if it had already gone. As if whatever was disappearing had already disappeared. As if it had already happened. And no one saw it go. Here today, gone tomorrow. This country, this America, this hubris. What a lament if no one saw it go. Dissipation is actually much worse than cataclysm.
Mrs. Fordham, are you firing me?
Barbara, no, no. I am giving you the opportunity to quit. I mean, there's work. Then there's work. I mean, after all, I'm here. Look around. No one else is here. You know, am I here or am I here? It's not that your services aren't necessary, it's just that I'm still here, goddammit.
I'm prepared to stay. I'm familiar with this job. I can do this job. I don't do it for you, or Mrs. Weston, or even Mr. Weston, right? Do for me.
Why?
I need the work.
What did my father say to you?
He talked a lot about his daughters, his three daughters and his granddaughter. That was his joy.
Thank you. It's good to know that you can lie. You can stay on. I'll take care of your salary. Don't worry about it. I'm still here, goddammit! Everyone just vanished.
Well, you're the one I want to talk to.
Oh, okay. Have a seat. Did you want some coffee?
Oh, no, thank you.
God, you look good. I mean, you really... filled out nicely. I mean, you look great.
Thanks.
What about me? Don't I look great?
Yes, I'm sorry, yes. You're looking really good. You really are.
Did you want some coffee?
No, thank you.
And you're the sheriff of all things? That's ironic.
How is that ironic?
Well, it's not. I misused the word ironic. God, if my husband could hear that. Well, fuck him. No, but it is incongruous.
Well, why is it incongruous?
Because of your dad.
Oh, I see you. Yeah.
Is he still alive?
Yeah. After a fashion. He has Alzheimer's.
Oh, that's awful.
Yeah, he's in a home over in Milwaukee.
Oh, that's just... You married? You're married. Did you want some coffee? I already asked you that. You're married.
Divorced.
Join the club.
Really?
Well, I mean, I'll be joining your club. Well, I mean, it looks like I'll be joining your club.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that.
Have kids?
$3.
Uh-huh. Look at that.
Really, I can't tell you how many times over the years I've thought about the Weston sisters.
It's been a while since I heard that. Sounds like a singing group.
I guess so.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I present the agitated Weston sisters.
Is your husband still here?
No, he left a few days ago. A week ago, 2 weeks ago. Back to Boulder with Jean.
She seemed pretty sweet.
She's a nymphomania.
Really?
Jean. That is a stupid name.
Well, I like it.
You know why we named her that? Bill's a big Jean Seberg fan. Now that's ironic.
I don't get it.
Jean Seberg died of a massive overdose of blah obituates.
Oh.
So.
Barbara, are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. I just got the plane.
planes.
I thought that maybe you and I could get some lunch together someday, you know. It's been a while. Mm-hmm. So I could get some lunch someday.
Mm-hmm.
The other reason I called was I got a call this morning from a woman named Chicha Nadu. She runs the Country Scribe Hotel. She was throwing out some old newspapers and she came across a picture of Mr. Weston that ran with his obituary, and she recognized him as the man that stayed at room 17 for 2 days, the first 2 days of his absence. He didn't make any phone calls, but she doesn't know if he received any. Now, I can run a check in the line to see if he received any phone calls anymore.
Do you have a cigarette?
Yeah, sure. Check with the phone company to see if you receive any phone calls if you are named.
No, that's not. I mean, what was he doing? Building up the confidence to jump in the water?
Or overcoming the confidence not to.
Right. I don't get that logic, but it doesn't matter.
Well, anyway, I thought you should know. So, can I call you sometime about lunch?
Is she clean?
Cleanish, so she's not clean. She's got brain damage, dummy. You think I'm gonna strip search her every time she slurs?
You know the difference.
She's moderately clean.
Moderately.
You don't like moderately? Then let's say tolerably.
Is she clean or not?
Back off. We're trying to get by here, okay?
I'm nervous.
Why? Oh, Christ, I mean not tonight.
Why not?
We're just now settling into some kind of rhythm around here. Now you want to come in here with your little itch.
I have to tell her, don't I? We're leaving for New York tomorrow.
It's not a good idea.
A good idea.
For you and little Charles to take things any further.
Where is this coming from?
I just got to thinking about it, and I think it's a little weird, that's all.
Well, it's not up to you.
Lots of fish in the sea. Surely you can rule out the one man in the world you're related
to. I happen to love the man that
love! What a crock of shit. People can convince themselves they love a painted rock. Looks great. What are we having?
Catfish.
Bob Peter's my favorite.
You think I shouldn't tell her?
You should rethink the whole proposition. New York City is a ridiculous idea. You're almost 50 years old, Ivan. You can't go to New York to break a hip. Now eat your catfish.
Oh, you are infuriating.
I am the one fucking my cousin.
I have lived in this town year in and year out, hoping against hope that someone would come and
help. Don't get all Carson McCullers on me. Now wipe that tragic look off your face and eat some fish.
Who are you to speak to me like this?
Hi, Mom.
What's happy about it?
Look, catfish.
Catfish.
Jana?
You hungry?
I'm not hungry.
Mom, eat your dinner, please.
I'm not hungry.
You didn't eat anything today. You haven't eaten anything yesterday. You're eating. You do what I say. Everyone, do what I say.
May I ask why neither of you is dressed?
What is it with you?
Yeah, we're dressed. It's not
like we're sitting around here naked, aren't we? Or did you want us to dress up?
Right, because you're coming up with a fish.
Right, because you're coming up with a fish. We need to dress up.
I'll eat my room.
That'll be fine, thank you. Eat.
No.
Eat it. Mom, eat it. No. Eat it. You fucker, eat that catfish.
Go to hell.
That doesn't cut any fucking ice with me. Now eat the fucking fish.
Mom, there's something I have to talk to you about.
No, you don't, Barbara. No, you don't. Shut up. Shut the fuck up.
Please. What is to talk about?
Mom, so forget it. Mom, did you eat your
I'm
fish?
I'm not hungry.
Eat it.
No.
Mom, I need to.
No.
Mom. Fuck. Eat the fucking fish, bitch.
Mom, please.
Barbara.
Okay.
Fuck it. Do what you want.
I have to tell you something.
I was a lesbian.
What? Barbara! No, you're not.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are. Did you eat your fish?
Barbara. Eat your fish.
Barbara, stop it.
Eat your fish.
Barbara, quiet.
Mom, please. This is important.
Eat your fish. Eat your fish.
She got it.
Why did you tell me?
Oh, goodness. You know, it's a good thing you all should know now anyway. You know, now that you're older, you never know if somebody's going to need a kidney transplant or something. It's just better that you should know.
Oh, my God.
I mean, you know, I don't see the benefit Charlie, little Charlie knowing, though. I mean, it'll just break his heart. How did you find out anyway?
Why did you tell me?
Why in God's name did you tell me that?
Now.
You are monsters!
You crazy nook!
Piggy, the bones of the rest of us! Monster!
Who do you think is your party leader?
I mean,
leave me alone!
Honey!
I won't let you do this to me!
Your nanny Faye told me I didn't know.
I won't let you change my story!
God damn it, I tried to protect you!
We'll go anyway. We will go away and you will never see.
Don't leave me like this!
You will never see me again!
I didn't tell you! Mom told you! It wasn't me, it was Mom!
There's no difference!
Now you know we couldn't let Ivy run off with little Charles. It just wouldn't be right. Ivy's place is here.
She says she's leaving anyway.
Oh no, she's not gonna leave. She's a sweet girl, and I love her to death, Ivy, I do. But she is not strong, not like you or me.
Right. So you've known about Daddy and Maddie Faye all these years.
Oh, I've always known. Father knew I knew. He always knew I knew. We never talked about it. I chose the high ground.
Right.
You know, I had to wait until Monday to get into that safe deposit box. And you know, because the bank was closed, and after I got into that box, I called the sheriff. And I guess I should have called them sooner, but
Father and I, we had an arrangement. Now, you gotta understand, for people like your father and me, people who never had money as kids ever, money's important to us.
How did you know where he was?
He wrote me a letter and said, he said I could reach him at the Country Squire Hotel. And I did. I called him on Monday.
After you got to the safety deposit box.
Well, Father and I had an arrangement.
If you knew Daddy was going to kill himself, you wouldn't have needed to get into that safety deposit box.
Well, I guess hindsight's 20/20.
Did the note say Daddy was going to kill himself? Mom?
If I had my wits about me, I might have done it differently. But I was your father, and Father and me, we were both fucked up.
You were fucked up. You are fucked up!
Now you listen here, you smug little ingrate. There is at least one reason your father killed himself, and that's you. Do you think he would have done what he done if you were still here? No, it was just him and me here, alone, abandoned in this house, wasted lifetimes devoted to your care and comfort. So go ahead, stick that knife of judgment in me, why don't you? Go ahead. His doing. He did this, not us. Could you think of anything more cruel than to leave me to handle this? Why? To weaken me? To make me prove my character? No, I'll leave it until I'm on my hands and that safety deposit box. But I would have waited anyway. Who do you say strong now, Belle? Nobody is stronger than me. When everybody's gone, when everything's gone and nothing's left and disappeared, who's stronger now, you son of a bitch?
No. You're right. You're the strong one.
Barbara, please.
Thank you.